Good morning, students. Today we are going to take up this poem from Flamingo, Keeping Quiet by Pablo Neruda. A little bit of background about the poet before we take up the poem. This famous poet, Pablo Neruda, this was his pen name, and his name was Neftali Ricardo Reyes Besalto. He was born in Parral in Chile. His poems are full of easily understood images, but that enhances the beauty of his poems. A man of varied talents, besides being a man of literature, he was also a politician, a diplomat. He contested for the presidency elections, and his poems, they deal with varied variety from erotic themes to revolutionary themes. He won the Nobel Prize for Literature in the year 1971. In this poem, Keeping Quiet, the title is suggestive. The poet talks about the necessity of quiet introspection, contemplating, thinking deeply about one's actions, and retrospection, thinking about, contemplating about one's actions in the past. And all this is essential for creating a feeling of mutual understanding among human beings. So let us read this poem first. Now we will count to 12 and we'll all keep still. For once on the face of the earth, let's not speak in any language. Let's stop for 1 second and not move our arms so much. It would be an exotic moment without rush, without engines. We would all be together in a sudden strangeness. Fishermen in the cold sea would not harm whales, and the man gathering salt would look at his hurt hands. Those who prepare green wars, wars with gas, wars with fire, victory with no survivors, would put on clean clothes and walk about with their brothers in the shade, doing nothing. What I want should not be confused with total inactivity. Life is what it is about. I want no truck with death. If we were not so single-minded about keeping our lives moving, and for once could do nothing, perhaps a huge silence might interrupt the sadness of never understanding ourselves and of threatening ourselves with death. Perhaps the earth can teach us when everything seems dead and later proves to be alive. Now I'll count up to 12 and you will keep quiet and I will go. So let us try to understand this poem line wise. The poet prepares mankind for introspection, urges them to remain quiet with a count of 12. 12 here represents the 12 hours in a clock, the 12 months of a season in a year, the 12 zodiac signs. For once on the face of the earth, What kind of silence the poet is expecting?